Out front tonight, the breaking news. Trump's real witch hunt. Because the president is threatening to punish people who disagree with him. And in this case, it's a very specific group of people, America's top former intelligence chiefs, the people who ran America's intelligence agencies.
Will the president consider Senator Paul's suggestion and call for the removal of former Director Brennan's security clearance?
Not only is the president looking to take away Brennan's security clearance, he's also looking into the clearances of Comey, Clapper, Hayden, Rice, and McCabe. The president is exploring the mechanisms to remove security clearance because they've politicized and in some cases monetized their public service and security clearances.
Let's be clear. It's an unprecedented thing if it happens. No president's ever done it, and it's an extraordinary list of people. The former CIA Director John Brennan, the former CIA Director and NSA Chief General Michael Hayden, former FBI Director Jim Comey, former Director of National Intelligence, that's James Clapper, former FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, and the former National Security Advisor Susan Rice. So I just want to be clear here that almost all these individuals have worked for both Republican and Democratic presidents, right, for decades in government to get to the top of those organizations, the CIA, the FBI, the NSA. The only exception who's only worked for Democrats is Susan Rice. What they actually all have in common is not their politics. What they have in common is that they have criticized this president. Here's a small sample.
I really do wonder whether the Russians have something on him. I think his behavior was just unbelievable.
I don't think he has a full an appreciation of Russian capabilities, Russians' intentions, and actions that they are undertaking in many parts of the world.
What his motivations are, I think, is a legitimate question, one that I trust that the special counsel is investigating. But the policies that this president has pursued globally have served Vladimir Putin's interests.
Yet the White House insists that the threat that they very explicitly labeled by name today is not personal or political.
Their free speech he doesn't like, and he wants to punish them for it.
No, I think you are creating your own story there. The president doesn't like the fact that people are politicizing agencies and departments.
Isn't the president doing exactly what you just said the president doesn't want all these people doing, politicizing matters of national security by going after his political enemies?
No, the president's not making baseless accusations of improper contact with a foreign government.
Now, when it comes to facts, the White House should be aware that Comey and McCabe actually no longer have their security clearances. So when she said she's looking into that, we can check the box there. You don't actually need to do that. They don't need to revoke them. General Hayden tells CNN he no longer even goes back for classified briefings. But if the president is serious about pulling security clearances for people who disagree with him, he's going to have his hands full. Because according to a report from the Director of National Intelligence, this year, more than 4 million people 4 million people have access to some type of classified information in America. That is a lot of people who may have criticized the president. So this idea of punishing your enemies or those critical of you, well, here's the thing. It's straight from the playbook of those the president admires, including strongmen, like the Turkish president, Erdogan. Here's President Trump at the NATO summit. Remember, he let Merkel and Macron and everybody, Trudeau, go ahead, and then he walked side by side with Erdogan, an autocratic leader who has reportedly arrested more than 100,000 people in a purge of his political opponents, including members of the military and judges. That's the model we're talking about here, because to strip the former intelligence chiefs of their security clearance is unprecedented. Never mind that the president's team didn't actually check the facts of who even uses those security clearances. This move today should upset all Americans. Jeff Zeleny is out front. And Jeff, the big question here is, you know, this comes out and they list all these names. Is this for real? Or are they just trying to change the conversation? What's going on?
Well, Erin, it certainly had that effect of changing the debate, changing the discussion. And I am told by a senior administration official just a few minutes ago that the president is, quote, more than comfortable with how all of this is playing out. He likes this debate in the public sphere. He likes to be having this argument against old Obama officials. This is not a new argument. He has been angry and seething at the Obama administration officials, who he is watching a lot on cable television. Let's be honest about this. So he likes this debate. The question is he ever going to go forward and actually do this and revoke those security clearances. That's what we don't have a clear understanding of. This administration official said he may at some point, but he's fine with this playing out as it's playing out. But it certainly did change the subject. We were talking about Iran, talking about the Russia investigation, the Putin meeting, and now we're talking about this. So we'll see if this is actually something he actually does, or if it's something like he has threatened before, like, you know, essentially firing Jeff Sessions. That has never happened as well.
Right.
So we will see how this plays out. But it is unprecedented. It is something that has never happened before. And the president seems to like this discussion. He thinks it fires up his base. It's the latest chapter in the deep state argument. Erin.
All right. Thank you very much. Of course, what fires up your base may or may not be good for the country, whatever your base may be, right? That's often the whole point about it. Out front now, Democratic Senator Ron Wyden is a member of the Senate Intelligence Committee. And, Senator, I appreciate your time. The White
House,
you heard, Sarah Sanders, said not just John Brennan. Let me just list all the rest of them, which she then proceeded to do. Brennan, Comey, Clapper, Hayden, Rice, and McCabe. Security clearances could be stripped. It would be an unprecedented action if it happens. Your reaction?
Erin, I have taken on the leadership of both political parties in the intelligence community. So I don't get a whole lot of invites out to Langley or Quantico. As I listen to this, it sounds to me like Donald Trump is talking about building an enemies list. And then the question would be, if that's the case, are taxpayer resources going to be used to go after critics?
I mean, that is the big question, right? And you heard Jeff Zeleny report he's more than comfortable with this conversation. The big question for you, Senator, is if he goes through with this threat, is there anything you in Congress can do about it?
Well, obviously, we're going to have Republicans get serious about pushing back. I mean, again and again, they have made excuses. It seems to me after last week, we ought to be talking about a bill that would sanction the Russians. We certainly, to protect our democracy, we ought to pass my bill to make sure that every American gets a paper ballot. So the Republicans are going to have to push back.
So, you know, former FBI special agent Frank Montoya told us, talking about the president doing this, it's an abuse of power, even though he does have that authority. Would you agree? The president does have the authority. If he wants to do it, Brennan, Comey, whatever, you guys are toast. I'm taking it away.
This is just plain wrong. I mean, the idea, and that's why I characterize it, of building an enemies list in order to look at the possibility or strategize at ways to go after your critics is contrary to everything that our country is all about. And that's why Democrats and Republicans are going to have to oppose it.
But, Senator, you said, all right, let's, you know, the Republicans need to step up, all right? So Sarah Sanders today, one of the top Republicans, I'm sorry, in the Senate, John Cornyn, responded this way to the news. I wanted to quote what he said to CNN. Some of these former officials have obviously donned the uniform of the opposition team to President Trump, and I can understand his aggravation, but I'll wait to see what he actually does. Now, look, Cornyn has criticized the president, but he's coming out today agreeing with the assessment that these former intelligence officials are on the opposition and saying he understands the president's aggravation. Doesn't sound like Republicans are jumping on board with your point of view.
I just hope that, and you saw this last week in the Senate on judges, that Republicans will come to their senses on some of these issues. They did when they said no to an extreme judge who also hid some very derogatory information about his background. They came to their senses. I hope they will here as well. And I think you asked what the motivation is. This is a twofer. Obviously, President Trump dislikes a number of these officials personally.
Yeah.
But this is also a major distraction. Look at what he's been doing the last few days. He has been twisting himself into a pretzel to try to make sure that people wouldn't think he's in Putin's pocket. So this is a twofer. He can go after his enemies, and it's a major distraction.
So the president called the Russia investigation, which you mentioned, a hoax in a tweet this weekend, right? This is after he said, oh, wait, I didn't mean to act like I was friends with Putin. I didn't mean it. Well, now it's back to being a hoax. He tweeted in part, so President Obama knew about Russia before the election. Why didn't he do something about it? Why didn't he tell our campaign? Because it's all a big hoax. That's why. And he thought crooked Hillary was going to win. Of course, obviously, a basic fact check here. Trump's campaign was informed of this. But the president's spokesperson said today that when he said hoax, he wasn't actually talking about the Russia investigation. So that, you know, we're back to the kind of, oh, let's try to backtrack. Here's how she put it.
The president is referencing the collusion component. Once again, the president has faith in the intelligence that suggests and maintained that Russia was involved in the elections. However, it's also important that same information concludes that it had no impact on the election, and that the president, again, would like to repeat that there was no collusion.
Again, just to make sure we put the facts out there, of course, he constantly questions whether Russia was involved in hacking the U.S. elections. But to her point, there was no collusion. And, you know, do you buy this explanation?
When I heard the senator's explanation, I said, you've got to be kidding me. They literally changed their position every few hours. And the president's credibility, in my view, has just evaporated. And as I have said several times in recent days, the fact is he didn't take on Putin when it really counted, and he's been trying to come up with one excuse after another for why he didn't.
Senator, do you think that if he goes ahead with this threat to strip these security clearances, an unprecedented action in the United States of America, that would be grounds for impeachment, or does that not go far enough in your view?
I will tell you that if he goes forward with what he's been talking about today, the idea of building an enemies list, and then we'd have the prospect of whether taxpayer funds were being used to deal with critics, I would rule absolutely nothing out if he pursued that strategy.